Here are fully functional replicas of classic car instruments. Based on semi-professional electronics, we are programming classic functions combined with modern features. Now they are all here, and I can show you how they are working. It was really worth the effort replicating classic analog instruments. And the circuit board is fully developed. Check out the previous videos if you are interested in that hardware. This video is about the features we are currently implementing, and we would love to hear your thoughts. So, feel free to leave lots of comments under the video. With this project, we are aiming to replace electromechanical gauges in classic cars. However, the drive can be used universally. Among us, I'd like to disclose a future project implementing a dial on a PCB. It's a great way to build a stable and durable instrument. The stepper drive is working clockwise or counterclockwise. The maximum deflection can be up to 315 degrees. By the way, we would be happy to talk about your idea. Just let us know. It was a challenge for us to build the instrument as a compact device. However, we had great support from PCBWay, the sponsor of this video. Look at this. Even these tiny labels come out perfectly. For this project, we are having the PCBs professionally assembled. This way, we can produce any quantity. Don't miss to check the great deals on PCBWay's website. Take the easy way with PCBWay. For the following tests, we are using the same hardware. I'm just changing the dial and the code for the corresponding instruments. It's ideal for use in vehicles. The electronic tolerates fluctuating supply voltage between 9 and 25 volts. Classic car sensors are components changing their resistance according to the engine temperature, fuel level or oil pressure. Regardless of sensor type, we are connecting it to the pin labeled sense. Different sensor and dial properties are considered in the code. The engine temperature is important to know, and I'm sure a classic car enthusiast always keeps an eye on it. According to experts, the optimal temperature is between 195 and 220 degrees Fahrenheit, corresponding to 87 and 104 degrees Celsius. Just as a side note, it's easy to replace Fahrenheit with a Celsius scale, for example. We were showing how to design it. When the engine is cold, the pointer is left off the scale. As an option, the blue LED is flashing as long as the temperature is below 100 Fahrenheit. Above 100 it's on constant, and above 140 Fahrenheit the blue LED is off. The idea is preventing you from revving up the cold engine. Now let's assume you lost cooling water and the engine is getting hotter and hotter. At a temperature of 225 Fahrenheit, the red LED starts to light up, and at a temperature of 240 Fahrenheit, it's flashing quickly. Given these indicators, you should stop immediately. If the sensor cable is broken, the pointer goes all the way to the left, and a few seconds later, the red LED starts flashing slowly. So, you don't have to warm up your engine to see if the instrument is working or not. The LED is signaling the malfunction. You saw it already with the temperature instrument. In this project, we are aiming to make the appearance close to the originals. The fuel level indicator goes over the scale when the tank is completely full. The pointer is moving slowly to avoid fluctuations from fuel sloshing back and forth in the tank while driving. At a level lower than 12.5%, the red LED lights up, and as soon as it is falling below 3%, it's flashing quickly. Then the pointer is left off the scale, similar to the original. With a broken sensor cable, a full tank is indicated incorrectly. In this case, the error signal is particularly valuable for obvious reasons. Depending on model and operating state, the normal oil pressure is between 25 and 65 psi, corresponding to 1.7 and 4.5 bar. Below 5 psi, the red LED lights up permanently. Below 2 psi, it's flashing quickly. In the oil pressure mode, a broken sensor is also indicated. Since the processor input is floating in that case, the pointer might start moving randomly. Besides the sense input, we have two voltage inputs for 0 to 5 volts and for 0 to 15 volts. The latter is applied to measure the vehicle's electrical system voltage. The car voltmeter has a special scale for the range we are interested in. Zooming into 11 to 15 volts improves the reading accuracy. When the engine is running, the battery voltage should be 13 to 14.7 volts and 12.4 to 12.8 when off. Below 12 volts, the battery is usually defective. In case we had to measure higher voltage, we would insert a series resistor here. We will explain how to dimension it on request. Battery health can be assessed even better, having an ammeter on board. I think it's a brilliant component, because it's measuring currents galvanically isolated. There is a separate video about its working principle on the channel. The so-called Hall sensor is connected to the 0 to 5 volt input, while the 5 volt output is serving as a power supply. We chose a sensor for plus and minus 100 amps, and I will definitely test the instrument in my car later. At the moment, I'm simulating the Hall sensor's output with my lab power supply, because I cannot generate 80 amps on my desk. Okay, there would be many more features possible. We were showing some currently under development. We can control blinking and brightness of three LEDs via the code. A warning beeper would be possible instead of one LED. What do you think? Feel free to leave your opinion in the comments. It is an anachronistic instrument that you can hardly buy anymore. A pointer that simply shows a measured value. It seems like a kind of luxury these days, when you don't have to click through 20 menus. Classic car enthusiasts like the devices anyway, and designing a dial face yourself is fun, just give it a try. Whether it's steampunk, science fiction, retro or avant-garde design, the drives completes your project. Now stay tuned and don't forget to support the channel. See you soon in the coming episodes.